Hi, I'm Josh Farkason, and welcome to Blood Pressure Audio-Visual Coordination Skills. There are several steps involved in taking a blood pressure measurement, and each step must be completed with accuracy. This is especially true when viewing the blood pressure dial and listening with the stethoscope. You must be able to effectively coordinate what you're hearing with what you're seeing. Just imagine if you recorded a patient's blood pressure as normal, when in actuality, their pressure was extremely high and they were at risk for having a stroke. Your inaccuracy can have dire consequences on the patient's overall health. This lesson will help you achieve accuracy when taking blood pressure measurements. By the end of this lesson, you will identify and interpret the graduation markings on an aneroid sphygmomanometer dial, and determine the systolic and diastolic blood pressure by reading the dial and listening to the Korotkoff sounds. If you ever had your blood pressure taken, you likely noticed that the results were stated as one number over the other number, such as 120 over 80. The number on top, in this case 120, represents systolic pressure, and the bottom number, in this case 80, represents the diastolic pressure. Let's take a close look at the dial used for determining such a measurement. This is the aneroid sphygmomanometer dial, also known as the blood pressure dial. The dial has the letters mmHg because blood pressure is measured in millimeters of mercury. Also on the dial, you'll notice that there are lines in various sizes. The largest lines represent values of 20. This is 20, this is 40, 60, and so on. The medium lines represent values of 10. This is 30, 50, 70, and so on. And the smallest lines represent values of 2. So this line represents 22, 24, 26, 28, and so on. Now let's use the needle to determine the number displayed on the dial. Concentrate on the tip of the needle and the line that it's pointing to. How much does this line represent? If you stated 68, you are correct. So how much does this line represent? If you stated 112, you are correct. And how much does this line represent? If you stated 294, you are absolutely correct. Great job. Now that you're comfortable with reading the blood pressure dial, let's apply audio-visual coordination skills. And for this, please increase your volume level and have a pen and paper on hand. There are two main areas that you need to focus on when determining a blood pressure reading. One, the position of the needle on the dial, and two, the Korotkoff sounds. We will refer to the Korotkoff sounds as thumping sounds for the duration of this video. When you arrive at the point of the procedure, when you slowly deflate the cuff to hear the sounds, you will notice the needle move in a counterclockwise direction. It is at this point that you need to listen very closely for the thumping sounds. Upon hearing the first thump, note the needle's position on the dial and record the number. That's the systolic pressure. As the cuff deflates and the needle continues to move, you will continue to hear the thumping sounds. Listen closely for the last thump. Upon hearing the last thump, note the needle's position on the dial. That's the diastolic pressure. Let's practice applying these two steps. Please note that your answer may be slightly different from what's displayed, but that's okay. As long as your answer is within 4 millimeters of mercury, your answers are still considered accurate. For example, if the displayed answer is 120 over 80, but your answer falls somewhere in the range of 118 over 78 through 122 over 82, your answer is still considered accurate. Of course, matching the displayed answer is the goal to achieve the most accurate answer. Listen closely and write down your answers. I will reveal the correct answer once the simulation ends. Here's the first one. Try another. Okay, and let's try one more. So, did you answer all of them correctly? Great job! Give yourself a huge pat on the back for a job well done. And there you have it. You have learned to identify and interpret the graduation markings on an aneroid sphygmomanometer dial, and determine the systolic and diastolic blood pressure by reading the dial and listening to the Korotkoff sounds. To stay up to date on other Allied Health learning tools, you can follow me on Twitter at AHTools1 or subscribe to my Allied Health Tools YouTube channel. Thank you for watching this video.